In the metals quadrant, gold definitely saw some profit taking today. We had a new high today. We're up almost 1% at 2089.20, just short of a retracement extension level. But that up 95 basis points did not last as we sold off in towards the day. We ended up finishing the day down over 1%, almost 1.5%, being down to a little bit less than 2.2% on the lows at 2024.80. So a very big profit-taking move, down 1.44% exactly on the close on very high volume and on an outside range day. What's an outside range day? Well, we had three previous days up. Then you have a day where the high is higher than the previous day, the low is lower than the previous day, and the close is lower than the previous day's close. So we had that higher high made, but then we made a lower low and closed below the previous day close. That's an outside range day. When that happens on a Friday, generally you see an extension of that move starting off the week, but quite a bit can happen over the weekend with a flight to safety asset like gold. So I certainly wouldn't depend on that particular technical signal for any sort of positioning in the short term. Now, we had really good jobs data in the US, which was also when the gold sell-off started to accelerate. Now, how do we know, again, that's profit-taking? Well, because of the volume we saw today. This was actually the highest volume day of the week, and that jobs data was very solid at 1.763 million jobs added versus 1.6 expected, 10.2% unemployment rate versus a 10.5%. unemployment rate expected, a higher work week, higher wages, everything was fairly solid. Even construction and manufacturing jobs were up along with service sector. So that took people out of that risk mode where they needed to have their flight to safety gold bundle in their portfolio. And that's where some of that profit taking came from. Very strong move. Gold was very overbought. This is the kind of data that can push it. And then lastly, the dollar was really, really strong today, putting in a correct double bottom, although it hasn't triggered. So there's no technical view that that's going to extend, but up 71 basis points. That's one of the biggest up moves we've seen in the dollar in a while. The dollar's actually up 3 of the last 6 days now, and that has an inverse correlation traditionally to gold. So the dollar being stronger also helped gold get weaker.